I am excited for today's training. Today, I will be talking about your relationship with you and how to create a better relationship with you. So I want you to know that this is going to be interactive, so please feel free to comment. I'm going to try and be checking the comments throughout. I'll be asking some questions. You can feel free to write things in there, ask questions, and we'll kind of just jump into creating a better relationship with you. So if you guys don't know yet, I am Karen Nelson and I am a life coach, and I specialize in working specifically with people who want to create more confidence and more self-love after divorce. I personally have been divorced for a little over 4 years, and I know exactly what it feels like when you don't feel like you're enough. I know exactly what it feels like to question your worth as a human and to struggle when it comes to making decisions as a single parent, and to struggle when you might be questioning, I don't know if this is the right thing. I don't know if I'm going to make enough money at the end of the month. I don't even know if I'm ready to jump back into the dating pool. Like, we all, especially as divorced people, have these thoughts about ourselves that just kind of sometimes keep us stuck, and it's not very fun. So I totally understand where you're at. I've been there. Maybe I'm even in the same position that you're at sometimes, but we're all in this together, and I am here to help you overcome challenges that you face as your divorce coach in this group, okay? So let's talk a little bit about what a relationship is. Tell me in the comments if you have any idea. What is a relationship? Anybody has anything to say? Okay, well, I'll tell you what I think a relationship is. A relationship is how we think about someone or something else. A relationship is all based on our thoughts about it. So I think very often we think that our relationship depends on if we're getting along with the other person or other people, if we are in close proximity to them, if we've seen them recently, if they have passed on in this life to another one. Often we think that that is what creates our relationship, but it really truly is our thoughts about someone or something else. So for example, I have a favorite podcast that I listen to almost weekly, and it's these two women co-hosts, and they are amazing. And I love them so much, and I laugh, and I feel very connected to them every time I listen to them. I often will get done with a podcast and think, wow, I feel like I could be best friends with these women. I've never met them. They don't know me, but I feel like I have a relationship with them. And it's because of the thoughts that I'm thinking. And this relates to any other relationship in our lives, including our relationship with ourselves. Our relationship with ourselves is based off of the story that we tell ourselves. It truly is how you think about you and the thoughts that you think about you. So we're going to talk about some of those thoughts today. So take just a minute. If that's what a relationship is the thoughts that you're thinking, and specifically we're talking about our relationship with ourselves, think for a minute, what is the story that you tell yourself about your life, about you? In particular, just think about it. Feel free to share anything in the comments if you'd like. But I'm going to go through a couple of examples here on thoughts that you may be having. And I just want you to think, is that how I'm thinking about my life? Are those things that come into my head? Now, again, no judgment on thoughts during these trainings. Every time we're taking a look at our thoughts, it is truly just to gain awareness, okay? Thoughts aren't bad to have. We want to have thoughts as humans. That's what makes us human and makes us individual and awesome. They're not bad. We just want to take a look at them. Okay, so when you think about your relationship with yourself and you think about your relationship with your life, do you think, my life is kind of hard and it's kind of unfair and it's not really turning out the way that it was supposed to? Odds are, if you're having thoughts like that, then you probably don't have a very good relationship with yourself and with your life. Now, there are many parts of your life that we are going to talk about today, and we will finish up with specifically your relationship with you. But I want to go through these, and I want you to kind of question, take notes, write things down, write thoughts down that you might have as I'm going through these different areas of our lives, okay? So the first one I want to focus on is your relationship with your body. Now, before I jump into talking about your relationship with your body, I want you to think about the parts of your brain that we use when we have thoughts. So we have two specific parts of our brain that focus on our thoughts. We have our default brain, which is our primal brain. It's in the amygdala, which is back here in the brainstem, and it is the part of our brain that evolved from our cave men and women ancestors from years and years and years ago. It's the part of the brain that there's not really any cognitive thinking. It's all based on habit. It's all based on protecting us. And that's the part of the brain that we normally use, and we just allow it to offer us whatever kind of thoughts that it wants to. And that's totally fine. There's nothing wrong with that. We do that naturally and normally as humans. But the part of the brain that I want you to start learning to focus on using is your cognitive part of your brain. It's your prefrontal cortex. It's right here, and it is the most evolved part of our brain. It is the part of the brain where you can intentionally choose thoughts to think. It's the part of our brain where we get to decide how we want to think and feel about ourselves. So one of my favorite thoughts is I like to talk to my brain more than I listen to it, because we get to decide where our brain focuses and the stories that we tell about ourselves. So I'm going to recommend that as you're going through these exercises and as you're learning more and more when it comes to dealing with your divorce and dealing with yourself and dealing with your life, that you try and intentionally choose thoughts that are going to serve you better than the thoughts that just your primitive brain serves up. Okay, so let's get back to how you think about your body. What is the story that you tell yourself about your body? Do you constantly beat your body up? Do you think that it's not good enough, that it's not beautiful or good looking? Do you think that maybe it's not the right size or the right shape? Or if you were just smaller or stronger or more defined? Or are you kind to your body? When you look at your body, do you think loving thoughts? Do you feel admiration for the way you look? Like, I really want you to start thinking about, what is this story that you're telling your body? And are these thoughts, and is this a story that you want to keep? So for me personally, I have struggled for years and years and years with my body image and the relationship that I have with my body. And especially when I was going through my initial separation and divorce, this is, Chris says, all the above negative thoughts. Yeah, I can totally relate, Chris, exactly how I feel about my body or how I felt. And I'm getting better. It gets easier the more you practice. But when I was first going through my separation and divorce, my self-esteem was so low, and I had the worst relationship with my body. I was so mean to it, and I knew that that had to stop. And so every single day, I just made a pact kind of with myself, and I just decided that every single day I was going to tell myself five things that I loved about my body. And they had to be things that I believed, but I had to tell myself five things. And so I started with, like, I love my curly hair, and I have a great smile, and I really like my collarbones, and my body is strong, and I can go for a walk or a run every single day if I choose. And I can't even remember what the last one was, but it was probably something like, I have strong legs. And so every single day, and for probably like the first little couple of weeks, I was saying the same five things, because I just wouldn't allow myself to love anything else about my body. And so when you're going through this, I want you to think about thoughts of, what am I thinking about my body right now? What is this story that I'm telling my body, myself about my body? And how do I want to start thinking about my body? what do I want my relationship with my body to be as I grow and learn more about creating a better relationship with myself? What do I want my relationship with my body to look like? So that's something that I want you to think about over these next couple of weeks, and even just the rest of today, as you're going about the rest of your day, kind of have these thoughts in the back of your head, like, what do I want that relationship with my body to look like? Because guess what? You get to decide how you want to think about your body. You get to decide if you want to keep beating it up, if you want to have a bad, terrible relationship with it, or if you want to be kind and loving to it. I promise you, I'm giving you permission right now, if that's what you're waiting for, to be kind and loving to yourself about your body. Now, this is what society wants us to think. Society wants us to think that if we beat ourselves up and we tell ourselves that we're the worst and we're fat and we look gross, that when we do that, it will be motivating and then we'll want to change. But I'm here to tell you, that does not work. It might work for a small, short interval, but then you will go back to loathing yourself. You will gain weight back. You will beat yourself up even more. You will have a lower self-esteem in the long run. Because I want you to think about it. When you think crappy thoughts about how you look, how do you feel? You feel terrible inside. You feel low. You feel unworthy. And when you feel terrible and unworthy and low, how do you act? You probably eat more food. You probably don't exercise because you think, well, what's the point? You probably maybe drink a little bit more to try and numb out that feeling of terrible and low and unworthy. And then that cycle just repeats itself. So do you see how beating yourself up to try and create motivation really isn't a good motivator? When you come from love and acceptance, that is what's going to make you start feeling confident and capable. And then you're going to start taking the actions that you want to maybe create a healthier body or just love your body where you're at, which is totally fine too. So start thinking about how you want to change your relationship with your body and how you want to start thinking about your body, and kind of write those out and start heading in that direction. Okay, so the next part of our relationship with ourselves that I want to focus on is our daily activities, like our daily life. Do you have a job? Are you a stay-at-home mom or dad? Do you volunteer? Do you spend time raising your kids? Do you go to their activities? Do you have a lot of hobbies and activities that you like to work on? And think about your thoughts about all of those things, all of the things that make up your day. How do you think about them? Do you, if you have a job, do you love or hate your job? Do you wish it was different? Do you wish you made more money? Do you think, well, I just never have enough time to do anything that I want to do. I have to give it off to, again, have to give all my time to everyone else. Are you overwhelmed? Do you feel stressed? Or do you tell yourself, I got this? Or I can totally handle all the challenges that come my way. Like, what is the story that you are telling yourself when it comes to your relationship with your daily life? For me, I want to give you guys an example of a job that I used to have. So for years and years and years, most of the years that I was married, actually, I was a medical transcriptionist. And it was nice because I worked from home, but definitely was not my dream job for sure. And I would say the majority of the time that I had that job, I badmouthed it every single day. I complained about every aspect of it. I complained about the people that I worked for and the people that I typed for and my boss and all the things that she emailed me about. And every time I got an email from her or a text message, I would read it in the meanest voice, like, she must have written this and have been yelling while she was writing it, right? Do we all do that with text messages? Somebody that we're like not very happy with, we just always read it in a very like condescending, mean tone. Well, I would do that with this job. And I would tell everybody who would listen how terrible my job was, how it was the worst, and how much I hated it. And then I started learning about thoughts and how they affect how we feel and how they kind of create our results in our life. And I decided I'm going to do an experiment. And And I'm just going to start looking for evidence that my job actually is not as bad as I'm making it out to be. And so I started looking and thinking, gosh, you know what? I actually make pretty good money with my job. And I work from home and it's pretty flexible hours. So I have kind of a lot of freedom to be able to like take my kids where they need to go, doctor's appointments, activities, all those kinds of things. And I started really working on when I get an email or a text, not reading it in a very condescending manner, but more of just like a curious, like maybe just like asking for something rather than demanding tone. And let me tell you, it completely changed my relationship with that job at that time. I started having a much better attitude. Everything completely shifted and I had a much better relationship with that job. I started to appreciate all of the things that it brought into my life and all the things that I could learn from having that job. So I want you to see that it truly is up to you to decide what is the story that I want to tell myself about how I'm spending my time. I get to decide if I'm stressed out and overwhelmed and if I hate every aspect of my day, or is there a different lens that I can focus on in that way? How can I refocus it to create a different, better relationship than the one that I'm seeing right now? So let me know if you guys have any questions about any of this. Now there are a couple other areas that I want you guys to think about over the next week or two when it comes to your relationship with yourself and with your life, where you can kind of do the same thing, like kind of think about what's the story that I'm telling myself right now and how do I want to change that? How do I want to think about it? So you could do your relationship with your time, your relationship with your home, like the place that you live, the city that you live in even, your relationship with your car, your relationship with money, which is a huge one, and I'll probably do a separate training just on our relationship with money, because this is a really big one that so many of us really have a terrible relationship with our money. So we'll probably focus on that one separately, but these are things that you can do just on your own and really focusing on how you want to think about them and focus on them. Okay, so let's jump into now your relationship with yourself. Now, like I said, your relationship with yourself is encompassed by your relationship with your life, right? Because we are part of our life. And so take just a few minutes and tell me, what are your thoughts that you have about your relationship with yourself? What do you think about yourself right now? And it can have to do with your body. It can have to do with who you are, with your worth, with your value, with whether or not you feel like you're good enough, you do things right or wrong. Like, what is your relationship with you? What do you think about you? Now, my guess is that you're going to start seeing some patterns as you start to write down or think about all these different aspects of your relationship with your life. If you kind of have negative thoughts and harsh judgments about your body and about your day-to-day life, you're probably going to have the same kind of thoughts and feelings about you as a person, about you as a human. Because normally, how we think about ourselves spills out into every other aspect of our life. And so if we're thinking we're not worthy, we're not good enough, we always do it wrong, often that will spill over into how you think about your job and how you think about the other people in your life and how you think about your body and how you think about your home, and just nothing is ever good enough, right? But I want you to see that if you can start to create more considerate, admiring, loving thoughts about yourself, most likely those are going to influence all of the other areas of your life as well. Okay, so how do we create a better relationship with ourselves? How do we even start to think better thoughts about ourselves or create a different story or look at our lives through a different lens? Well, there's a couple of things that I want you to focus on as you as a human. The very first thing that we all need to recognize and realize, and this might seem a little corny, but I promise you, if you don't have a good relationship with yourself, you are not thinking about this in this way. But each and every one of us truly, truly is a miracle. I want you to think about what it takes to create a human being. It takes a sperm fighting insurmountable odds, one sperm fighting insurmountable odds to make its way to the egg and fertilize that egg. And then once it's fertilized, it has to go, this tiny, tiny cell has to grow through this process of 9 months inside a mother's womb or inside a womb, creating all the different parts of the body, the muscles and the tendons and the bones and the vessels and the brain and all of the things that make up us as humans. Think about this for just a minute. How amazing our brains are. Our brains are the most advanced than anything else on this planet. We truly are, as human beings, miracles. And the more you can appreciate that, even just that, knowing that one thing about yourself, that right there can change the focus of how you think about yourself in just that one tiny way. The next thing that I really want you to recognize about yourself when it comes to you as a human and creating a good relationship with you is I want you to recognize that we are each different and unique and individual. We all have different strengths. We all have different weaknesses. None of us are any better or worse when it comes to our strengths and our weaknesses. Like one strength isn't better than someone else's strength. They just are our strengths and our weaknesses. And they are what make us unique and special and amazing. So my friend Jody likes to use this analogy and I love it so, so much. But she always says, when we're born, it's like we're packed with this suitcase, right? And in each suitcase comes our strengths and our weaknesses and our traits. And some of us came with more patience and some of us came with more sympathy. And some of us came with less of those things, but some of us came with maybe a more analytical mind or the ability to be easygoing or the ability to be more fun-loving and spontaneous. Like we all have these different things that were packed into our individual suitcases when we came to this earth. And just because we didn't come with something doesn't mean that we can't work to develop it or work to overcome a weakness that maybe we were given. It just means that we have to put a little more effort into getting there. But the point is that each of us has different things that we brought to this earth that came as part of us as humans, as part of our personality. And it doesn't make us any better or worse than anyone else's. It just makes us who we are. It makes us individual. And the more that you can recognize that and own that and be appreciative of that, that is where the roots of loving yourself will start to take hold. So over the next few weeks, I really want you to start thinking and deciding on the story that you want to start telling yourself about you. You are an amazing individual, and you get to decide what the story is that you tell about yourself. You can think about yourself in a way that makes you feel terrible, which is probably similar to what you're thinking and feeling right now, and that's okay. You get to think and feel whatever you want. I am never telling you you should think this way or you should feel this way, but I just want you to know that you have options. And if you are tired of feeling terrible and thinking terrible thoughts about yourself, you can choose to change it. It's totally okay for you to think about yourself in a way that makes you feel good. And what's the downside to that? There really isn't a downside when you think about it. So take some time over the next week or two and write down the story that you have about yourself right now. And if you embraced every part of you and you learned to love every part of you, what would your new story be? I really want you to think about that. That is good work for you to do. So last year, toward the end of the year, I read Matthew McConaughey's book, Green Lights. And if you guys haven't read this book yet, it is so good, so amazing, so insightful. But what I really enjoyed so much about this book is I was talking to my boyfriend after I finished reading it, and I said, you know, it's so interesting, but Matthew McConaughey just seems like he has had the perfect life. Like nothing really bad happened to him. And then a few hours later, I was thinking about that statement and thinking about the book, and I was like, that is not true at all. Matthew McConaughey talks, like his whole entire book is full of hard things that he went through. It's full of great things too, but it is not at all a book about nothing bad ever happening to him. The thing that makes it seem that way is that Matthew McConaughey wrote that book to tell his life story where he is the superhero of his story. He is a superhero, and I want you to start thinking about your life and your relationship with yourself from the point of view of being the superhero in your story. Not changing anything that has happened, not changing any of the experiences or pretending like they didn't happen, but just changing the focus of the lens and deciding, how do I want to think about this instead? Because it really, truly is up to you. Okay, so does anybody have any questions on creating a better relationship with yourself? I want you to know that now that you have some things that you can start thinking about when it comes to the thoughts that you have about yourself, if you want to take this to the next level, I am here for you. I want to invite you to jump on a free coaching call with me. During the 30 minutes, you are going to be able to tell me all of the things that you hate about yourself or all of the thoughts that you have about your relationship with you that you want to change. All of the things that you feel like are probably holding you back in some way when it comes to moving on after your divorce, when it comes to creating the kind of life that you want for you and your kids, when it comes to maybe even stepping into that dating pool, wherever you're at, we're going to talk about those things. And I want you to know that you are going to come away from this call knowing exactly how you can create a better relationship with yourself, feel confident in making decisions for you and for your kids, and really creating the kind of growth and change that will come when you create that better relationship with you. So I'm going to put the link to schedule a free consultation call with me in the comments. And feel free to schedule that there, or you can also always go to my website, KarenNelsonCoaching.com, and schedule there as well. So I usually do trainings every week or two. If you haven't checked out any of the other trainings, you can go to media, and then all the videos, all the previous trainings are in there. I've done some on confidence and loving yourself more, working on your self-esteem, and then also I'm trying to remember what I did last time and it's not coming to me, but it's in there. You just go to media and that is where you will find the other trainings, and this one will be in there as well. And like I said, I have plans to do more trainings on our emotional well-being, being willing to handle our own emotions. Triggers was the other one that I did. Sorry, it just came to me. So I did one on handling triggers, and there's going to be lots more. And like I said today, I'm going to be doing one in the future on our relationship with money, because that is a really big one that so many of us overlook in our lives, that relationship that we have with money, and it can truly change your life when you start to think about it in a different way. So thank you guys so much for being here. You can always message me if you have questions, and thanks for showing up, and I will see you guys in the group for another training. Bye.